Okay, so in our browser, I've reloaded the page, and let's test out all that new code we just wrote. Okay, so I added steak, and you can see it reloaded the page, food equals steak in the URL, and it added our shopping list. So now you can see what we've been working towards this whole time. Let's take a quick view of the source code of this file. So you can see our form here, and you can see we stuck in the input hidden value equals steak, and then on our shopping list that we appended to the end of that output HTML, you see a list item for steak. Let's go ahead and try adding another food, eggs. You can see what's on my mind this morning. Okay, so you can see we have both our elements in the URL. That's because when this page loaded last time, it had steak as a hidden input, remember? And when we submit the form, the hidden input stays preserved. Let's look at the source for this version of the page now. And you can see we have two inputs, two hidden inputs, one for eggs and one for steak. And then we can see we have the list items we've been adding. Notice that the white space here is kind of messed up. HTML always puts list items, unless you style it otherwise, on their own line. So independent of whatever white space is in our source, HTML will display it. Let's try, just for fun, adding something to the URL here. How about food equals pizza? And when I hit enter, we get pizza added to our list. Let's go through this code one last time so you can understand fully what just happened. We've got our form HTML, which renders the basic form. And inside that form, that's where we're adding in the hidden inputs. If I were to view the source of a version of this page, you would see that we have three hidden inputs when we have three items, food items in the URL. The HTML that describes those hidden inputs is here. Now, in our code, we said that if there were any items in the URL, any items that come from the food parameter, that we would do all of this string formatting here, where we basically build up a list of the hidden items, and then build up a list of the list items, these bits of HTML here, and then concatenate everything together, putting the items into the list, and then putting that whole shopping list at the end of our output. And then finally, we substitute our hidden HTML that we've been building up into our output string, and we write the whole thing back to the user. So the functionality we get here is kind of a neat side effect of how storing data in the URL allows us to build this fake shopping list functionality. But it was a little bit of a pain to write. Okay, and now it's time for one of those quizzes where you probably already know all of the answers. So what is wrong with that previous solution that we just went through? Check all that apply. One, it's a pain to change. Next, we don't get any syntax highlighting in our HTML. Our code is ugly, and it's very error prone. And I left out of the video the part where I was swearing trying to get all of this working for you. Okay, check all that apply.